Good afternoon, everybody out there in YouTube land. This is CW. Thank you for joining me this afternoon for another video. Today I wanted to take a look at this outdoor element haul. It's a haul, I guess. I don't know. Got some items from Outdoor Element, a company that specializes in outdoor and camping equipment. I think they're out of Colorado, I believe. Mom and pop company, I think, you know, small business. I've been seeing the fire beaners, so I wanted to get one of those. I ended up getting like a 10% discount. I found a 10% code online, so I said, all right, I'm going to do it. So I got the fire beaner, and I got a wombat whistle tender kit, and a woolly mammoth hemp survival bracelet. We're going to try these out. Well, we're not really going to try these and that yet, not just yet. We're going to check these out. Supposedly you can change the flint in the fire beaner with this screwdriver, specialized screwdriver. I think you might be able to use anything that'll fit in the slot probably, but that's just specialized for it, I guess. Might as well. All right, let's take a look at those. And then I found a fire beaner knockoff on Vipon, the Vipon coupon, and ordered one of those. So we'll take a look at that and see how it compares against the original fire beaner. And it came with its little old tender on its own too. I got some different kind of tenders we'll try out with it. Some Zippo tender, some fire paste. We'll check these out here in just a minute. Stay tuned. Showing here how to screw. There's the little screw for the flint right there. Okay. just use this little tool to get unscrew that little bitty screw right there. Change the flint. Oh man. Alright, let's take a look at this Vipon carabiner. Firebeaner. This one came with this made in China brand. Came with a piece of cotton tinder. That's just regular old cotton tinder right there. Doesn't feel like it has anything on it. Doesn't smell like it has anything on it. It's got some little hex screw splots and rope cutter. The Firebeaner original has a rope cutter. Looks like it's a replaceable blade on that rope cutter. And a little screwdriver end right there. So let's take a look at this one. See the rope cutter on the China brand and the rope cutter on the Firebeaner brand. Let's check those out real quick. We'll take this piece of jute. The woolly mammoth. Goodness, it doesn't really want to cut that jute, because that jute's pretty tough. Try this one. Oh, that one don't really want to cut the jute either. Well, if on that then, I guess you have to have a pretty thin wire, right? Would have failed on that one. Better we use the lighter, bro. Cut a couple of pieces of jute off of here. Oh man, these skeeters out here. Alright, we'll try those out. Alright, let's try this out. We'll untwine some of this jute. Some fibers will fine and hopefully catch a spark. We didn't even need that whole piece. We probably won't need that whole piece. Which way does it say? Oh yeah, the arrow says go this way. Alright. Oh, there we go. Pulled apart there, other little fine little fibers. And put it together, back together a little bit. Ooh, wrong way. Uh-oh, getting all caught up in the wheel. Well, this one doesn't seem to want to... Give this black one more try. Well, there it goes, finally. Let's try a Zippo lighter. Zippo fire starter. In a survival situation, I may not survive with this one. Ooh-wee, I'm telling you, my finger's getting tired now, jacking around with this. Try this one that came with the Chinese brand, the China brand. keeps getting up into the wheel. It'll start cutting. Yeah, they don't seem to want to be doing too much other than cotton. What about some lint? Well, I guess if he can do a cotton ball, he can do lint, right? We hope. We would hope so. This is the lint from the Freshly box. If you haven't seen that video, you should probably check that out, the Freshly box review. There it goes. If you put a little bit of petroleum jelly on that, it'll help it out some. Surely this one will do it. Come on. Don't make me have to be a liar now. Come on. Ooh, you skeeters. Kind of uncomfortable because it's small like that. I guess if you have a smaller hand, it wouldn't be so bad. God dang it. Alright, this Coughlin's fire paste right there. Put some of this. Oh man. See what happens there. Oh my gosh, I hope I don't have it in my hand now. God damn. I think the flint is out on this one already. Looks like you gotta take apart the is that you gotta take it apart to get the flint replaced. Oh no, there it goes. Wow. That was so smooth, man. Who wasn't it? Hold it up. Almost. Oh, goodness. Yeah, my hand's getting tired now. Try that with the lighter, bro. Goodness, that worked pretty well. Right, so this fire beaner says it holds, it has 100 pound capacity. This made in China brand doesn't really say what the capacity is on it. I don't know. They're, neither one of them were really worth a darn starting fires except for cotton. And even that, it was pretty iffy with the China brand. The fire beaner did fairly well on cotton, but not too much up after that. I don't know, you might do. And jute, it worked pretty well on jute, right? So that was that. These are a couple of fire beaners supposed to be able to start fires with these. They do put out a little bit of sparks, but getting much more than really dry jute or really dry cotton. It's not really looking too well for these. All right, thank you so much. You have a good night, good day, good weekend, whatever time it is you're watching. You have a good one. Please click like and subscribe, maybe a share or two on social media. Thank you so much. Have a good one.